first time you leave, it can be strange, it can be shocking. Not everybody drives a truck, not everybody drinks sweet tea, not everybody owns a gun, wears a ball cap, boots and jeans. Not everybody goes to church, watches every NASCAR race. Not everybody knows the words to Ring of Fire or Amazing Grace. Oh, Dancing Land.
Hey everybody, it's Small Town Saturday.
We're once again recording Small Town Saturday on a Sunday. That's just going to be the thing.
It's what we do.
We needed more time for research.
We'll go with that. We actually have a couple towns to discuss today. Just real quick.
A town and a couple of isolated locations at other towns.
Okay. Well, we'll start with Aitkin.
Oh, yeah. Two towns then.
Okay. So, I don't even remember. That was a couple days. That was...
That's the one where we had the campground and we had to walk to the grocery store. It's the strip through, like, the main street's really cute. There's a good coffee shop there that had free Wi-Fi.
Mm-hmm. And they had sandwiches, too.
Mm-hmm. Sandwiches and stuff.
That's where you had the goat picture. We'll put the goat picture up.
Yeah, so there was, like, a little gift shop that had these metal farm animals. And there's a picture. It's actually my profile picture right now on Facebook of a goat. It was a small little baby-sized goat. It was so cute.
And then...
the grocery store was pretty on point.
We had to walk. We walked like just over a mile and a quarter each way. Mm-hmm. But they had some good stuff there. It was actually really good. Good selection. And
they had cinnamon buns. Cinnamon rolls.
Oh, yeah. From the bakery.
So we got some of those. And they were yummy.
And the town in general was really cute. People were super nice. Mm-hmm. The riverfront area was nice. The campgrounds wasn't too bad either. It was a county-run campground.
It was a little weird because a million people drive through that campground. It's, like, really, like, off the beaten path a little bit near the waste management, like, site, and there were cars going through there all the time. And granted, there were people, like, also using the path to walk their dogs or ride their bikes, but there's just a whole bunch of just people driving by to scope it out, which we didn't really understand.
Both days, actually.
Mm-hmm.
It must be a thing. I mean, it is on the river, and I guess that might be one of the only access points, so they were just checking out the river or something.
Well, some people did a little bit of fishing too.
That's true. But overall, we liked the town. It was good.
Yeah, it was a good stop.
Mm-hmm.
The next small town is Little Falls. So Little Falls is where we ended up after having to come off the river, which we explained in the previous video.
Because I'm broken.
And it just so happened we went and got our haircut at the Great Clips, and we were talking to the ladies. Yep, see? We were talking to the ladies, and it just so happened that the Dam Festival was going on, and there was going to be a parade at 11 o'clock through town.
Mm-hmm.
And it was precious. It was a pretty long parade.
Well, first we went for coffee at that cool place.
Oh, they told us a place to go to coffee, and it was called Zoomskis,
that's right.
And there's a woman named Kate there, and she was super friendly, and the coffee was really good.
Mm-hmm.
And
they had Wi-Fi.
Everyone seemed to really like their food that they were getting. We didn't get food there, but...
Mm-hmm.
Everyone else seemed to really enjoy their food. Cute little place.
And then we went to downtown, which is right on the river. It's a really cute downtown. They've got a lot of storefronts and parks, open space, stuff like that. So we found a parking, really easy parking too, actually, just off the parade path, kind of toward the end. And yeah, it was a really long parade, given the small town atmosphere of it, but... Mm-hmm. Random tractors, fire department.
Couple marching bands.
Yep, local schools, football teams.
Did you see the tractors on?
Tractors, various farm entities, a couple politicians, sheriff's department.
And then local businesses.
Yeah. I mean, it was a good, probably hour and a half almost.
Mm-hmm. I would guess that.
Yeah. So it was fun. For a random festival.
You could tell it was a small town because people were yelling across the street to the other people and being like, oh, hey, Sue, hey, Bob, how you doing? Like, you could tell everybody knew everybody. really cool. Mm-hmm. So after that, we went down to like one of the parks where a bunch of different vendors were set up, and Rachel noticed that there was one vendor there that was giving away free massages. So we said, yes, please. So we got like a free, I don't know, 5 or so minute massage, mm-hmm. neck and back and stuff. It was like one of those chair massages.
I think I have a photo of that too.
Maybe. Oh yeah, we took a picture with the two ladies.
Mm-hmm. Right in the riverfront.
Yeah.
Right by the, well, the falls, the dam.
The dam. Mm-hmm.
And then we were going to walk to the food trucks, but I think you saw that one,
mm-hmm.
for a local chiropractor, and no one was there at the time, so we were going to keep an eye on it, but just as we were walking away, one of the gals from the office and the chiropractor, the doc, showed up, and they were only supposed to be doing
massages,
like chair massages, but I told the doc what was up, and that we've been to the chiropractor before, and this is what's going on, this is what we're doing. He's like... So he took me kind of off to the side. I was like, oh God.
He's like, this is not happening. We're like, gotcha.
Got it. So he did some really kind of pretty amazing adjustments.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt really great for like an hour. Like I was standing up straight. I felt taller. There was no pain.
Even now you're not as bad off as you were.
Yeah, it's been coming back, but it made a dent in it.
So that day was just really great for our healing. And then we started driving down the river road. There's the Charles Lindbergh
Historical Site Park. And you can do tours there. They have the live person, what do they call
them? Yeah, living history, I think is what they mm-hmm. call that, where people dress up and portray a particular character from history.
So it's cool. We didn't do any of the tours, but we stopped by and went through the gift shop and used their potties.
Yep.
But then we kept going because we had other things to do.
We have plans. So I think that's it for Little Falls. Definitely a cute place.
Mm-hmm.
A good small town. Our next town was St. Cloud, which honestly, St. Cloud is starting to get into like the bigger cities. And so it was more chain stores and just not a whole lot to talk about, except for one location. The bookstore.
Oh yeah, the bookstore.
It's called, I think, Books Revisited. It's a used bookstore.
I got some pictures.
You want to tell them about it?
This place was awesome. The whole gamut of book genres were there. But really old books. He showed us one from
1830-something?
Yeah. We didn't touch it, but we looked. Mm-hmm. But it was really cool. I could spend hours and probably days in there just looking through everything, all the older books and
stuff. Yeah, you got some books for like $3 and then some books for like hundreds of dollars. Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I just have a feeling you could find like whatever you are looking for mm-hmm. in there. So we got a couple more books in each of the series that we're reading.
And I picked up an old book. It's pretty much like stories from like Abe Lincoln and Grant and all that. Just important stories from the early Republic, the early history. And then we actually gave the guy two of our books, and I thought we were just going to give it to him, but he gave us $6 off because he essentially bought the books from us.
Yeah.
So we got a little bit of a discount on that. I could totally go back there. That place is pretty cool.
Yeah, I could have spent a lot more time in there. And money, probably.
Yeah. Oh, what was the hotel that we stayed at in Little Falls?
Country Inn and Suites.
Country Inn and Suites. If you're in Little Falls, that place is really cool for the price.
They have a laundry facility, too.
They do. It's just a washer and dryer, but it's there.
They had a hot tub.
Hot tub and pool. They had a really breakfast. Good breakfast. And really big rooms.
Oh, yeah, the rooms was big.
Like... studio apartment size rooms.
Yeah. Like a little kitchenette, kind mm-hmm. of.
And in comparison to the one that we stayed in
St. Cloud,
it for the same price, it wasn't nearly as impressive. But yeah. So that was Small Town Saturday.
Yeah.
That hit all of the...
Anything good to say about Minneapolis?
They don't have any...
No, anything good to say? Oh, we did go through Anoka. And we'll be back there on Tuesday for the federal tour. But we stopped at Han's Bakery in Anoka. And yes.
Good stuff.
Very popular, we could tell.
All the good stuff was sold out by the time we got there.
Like the maple bacon long johns and the
apricot twists.
Apricot twists. But it's okay. We'll be back there Tuesday morning and I will get those.
And we got a discount from Caribou Coffee.
Oh, yeah.
I guess Caribou's really big up here, which is better than Starbucks, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So that was cool. All right. I think that's it.
That's it for Small Town Saturday.
We're going to gather up some questions and think about our answers for a minute, and then we'll get you a Q&A Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see you next time. Everybody, we just watched the parade and now we're walking through the little festivities and we got a free chair massage for about 10 minutes.
Do you see these faces? These are happy faces.
And then we happened to cross a chiropractor tent and they were actually offering other free massages, but we told them what we were doing and the issues I had in my back and he's like, well, just come over here, we'll see what we can do. He's like, you know, no one else saw us do this, but he adjusted both of us.
Dude, it's like tingles going down your back. I had a bunch between my shoulders that needed adjusting and then a little bit by my neck.
And I feel a lot lighter. My back's still a little angry, but it's worlds better, so.
You're practically in tip-top shape, probably at least as good as you were when we started paddling.
Yeah, so today's been a good day.
This is exactly what we needed. Exactly.
And now we're going to go check out all the food stands here and just enjoy the rest of the day.
And we may go tubing this afternoon.
Yes.
On a tributary of the Mississippi, Platte River. So hopefully we'll make that happen.
Stand by for further.
Saw granddaddy down here. They only come a town about twice a year. You buy 100 pounds of yeast and some copper line. Everybody knew that it made money shine. Now the revenue man wanted granddaddy bad. Head left a holler of everything he had. For my time, but I've been told you never come back from Copperhead Road.